Let me start with the conclusion. Tesla is no longer being priced as a car company. Tesla just hit a new all-time high near $498, and this move isn't about short-term hype. It's about something deeper. While one autonomous system stopped working during a real-world crisis, Tesla's FSD kept going, and the market noticed. Today, I want to explain why this moment matters, what most people are missing, and why even at all-time highs, Tesla's story may only be getting started. Hi, this is Ken. If you're a Tesla investor or someone seriously following AI and autonomy, this video is not about headlines. It's about understanding how the market is quietly redefining Tesla, why Wall Street looks cautious while price keeps rising, and how long-term investors should think about Tesla from here. By the end, you'll see why recent events are less about price and more about proof. Here are the key facts. Tesla stock reached a new all-time high, up more than 3% in a single session. At the same time, Goldman Sachs reiterated a neutral rating, citing regulatory risks. Meanwhile, in San Francisco, a major power outage caused hundreds of autonomous vehicles from Waymo to stop operating. Tesla vehicles using FSD, they kept driving. And in the background of all this, Elon Musk's net worth surpassed $700 billion, driven largely by Tesla's rising valuation. These events may seem disconnected. They're not. Transition, connecting the dots. To understand what's really happening, we need to move beyond ratings, headlines, and price targets. We need to talk about how autonomy works in the real world. The San Francisco blackout is more important than most people realize. Waymo's system relies heavily on infrastructure, high-definition maps, traffic signals, external systems behaving as expected. When the power went out, that environment collapsed. Tesla's FSD is different. It doesn't wait for perfect conditions. It doesn't depend on external signals being on. It observes the world through cameras and makes decisions in real time. This is the key distinction. Autonomy isn't about memorizing rules. It's about understanding reality. That night in San Francisco wasn't a press release or a demo. It was a stress test, and Tesla passed it quietly. So, if Tesla's technology is proving itself, why are firms like Goldman still neutral? The answer is regulation. Especially in California, there are concerns about how FSD is marketed, named, and supervised. These are not technical limitations, they're legal and political ones. But here's the key insight. Regulation almost always lags capability. We saw it with smartphones, we saw it with ride sharing, and we are seeing it again with AI. Regulatory friction doesn't stop technology. It slows adoption temporarily while society catches up. The market understands this, even if analysts hesitate to say it outright. Transition from risk to repricing. And that's where the stock price comes in, because price doesn't reflect certainty, it reflects direction. Tesla at $498 isn't being valued as an EV maker with margin pressure. It's being valued as a platform. FSD, AI training, robotics, data at scale. The market isn't waiting for perfection. It's recognizing momentum. When investors reprice a company, they don't wait until everything is finished. They move when the outcome becomes probable. Here's the surprising part. The most bullish signal wasn't the stock price. It wasn't even the FSD performance. It was the silence. Tesla didn't run ads. They didn't publish a victory blog post. The system just worked. In technology, reliability under stress is worth more than any demo. And the market understands that instinctively. Looking ahead, this is what matters. FSD doesn't need to be perfect to change transportation. It just needs to be consistently better. Each real-world edge case, each unexpected event, trains the system further. And once autonomy reaches a certain threshold, scaling becomes exponential. This is why Tesla isn't just competing with other automakers. It's competing with human driving itself. For long-term investors, the question isn't, is Tesla expensive today? The real question is, what kind of company will Tesla be 5 or 10 years from now? A car company sells units. A platform scales intelligence. The market is slowly choosing which story it believes. Tesla at all-time highs feels uncomfortable. That's normal. But historically, the most uncomfortable moments are when a company's identity changes. What we're seeing now isn't speculation, it's early validation, not certainty, direction. So I'll leave you with this thought. Do you see Tesla as a manufacturer reacting to regulation, or as an AI company learning faster than the world can adapt? That perspective will shape every decision you make from here. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Before we wrap up, let me take a moment to introduce myself. I drive a Tesla Model Y, and at home, I've installed a Tesla Powerwall, so I actually charge my car with solar energy. I truly believe Tesla is shaping the future, and that's why I share the latest news and insights here on this channel. I'm from Japan, but I want to connect with Tesla fans all around the world. That's why I also create an English version of my videos. YouTube now lets you switch the audio into your own language, so you can enjoy it in whatever language you prefer. Most of all, I'd love to connect with Tesla fans everywhere so we can support Tesla together. I also share updates on X, so feel free to follow me there and let's connect. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.